Arduino analog output 0 to 5 volts with PWM signal linearity check. Hello friends, how are you doing? Let's talk about analog outputs for Arduino controllers. Analog inputs 0 to 5 volts are familiar to you, they are in many popular controllers. And the topic of analog outputs in the Arduino community is usually hushed up and rarely raised. And no wonder, because the Arduino controllers do not have them. We usually replace them with PWM outputs without even thinking. The analog output signal has standard ranges of 0 to 5 volts, 0 to 10 volts, 0 to 20 milliamperes or 4 to 20 milliamperes. I've seen a controller with 1 or 2 0 to 5 volts analog outputs, but it's not from the Arduino line. Also, such outputs are widely used in industrial controllers. The PWM signal can in some cases be used directly as an analog output, for example when controlling the brightness of an LED. In this case, our output pulses are smoothed out by the slow reaction of our eyes, and indirectly it seems to us that the voltage on the LED is simply changing. The second example is the control of the rotation speed of a collector motor directly with a PWM signal. In this case, the pulses are smoothed by the inductance of the motor windings and indirectly a full-fledged analog output is obtained. But there are also tasks in which you need to receive a 0 to 5 volt signal at the Arduino output. For example, when developing a signal generator, an analog signal converter, in various measurement tasks. To convert the PWM pulse signal into an honest 0 to 5 volts analog output, use an RC filter. In my case, the smoothing capacitor is inside the voltmeter housing. To study the PWM output, I will take an analog high-precision voltmeter. In this case, the pulse signal will be smoothed out by the capacitor, the inductance of the voltmeter coil, as well as the inertia of the indicating arrow. In this study, I want to dispel my suspicions about the low accuracy of such an indirect analog output. And the most important criterion for accuracy here for me is the linearity of the output signal depending on the value of the PWM signal, which we set programmatically. If the linearity is lame, then the signal generator, for example, will generate curved signals and measurement tasks will be very difficult to solve. The circuit is simple. The voltmeter is connected to the D3 pin of the Arduino Nano, which supports physical PWM. I also showed the capacitor that is installed inside the voltmeter. The program will also be concise. PWM signal is applied to pin D3, and the PWM value will be set manually through the port monitor. Pin D3 is configurable as a discrete output. The if conditional statement watches for the command to appear from the port monitor. We read the given PWM value into a variable of type string. We duplicate the received command back to the port monitor for self-control. Convert the string variable to an integer variable PWM value. We set the new PWM value to the discrete output D3. Further, this value will remain until we set a new one. A voltmeter has a full scale of 5 volts. A value of 150 is 5 volts. 30 is 1 volt, 60 is 2 volts, 90 is 3 volts, 120 is 4 volts. The program is already loaded into the Arduino Nano. I open the port monitor. I enter the value 255. And the possible range of the PWM signal for the Arduino Nano is from 0 to 255. We see that the voltage does not reach 5 volts significantly. Now I enter half the PWM scale 127. On the voltmeter, the voltage turned out to be about half of the previous one. And now I measure all the PWM values in steps of 10 units and write down the corresponding voltages at the output of the Arduino Nano pin. I will summarize all the data in a table for plotting. so I wrote down all the data. Now just enter the PWM value of 255. The table and graph turned out like this. In the first column of the table, the readings of the voltmeter on its scale. In the second column are the values of the PWM signal. In the third column, the converted readings of the voltmeter in volts. The maximum voltage value at the discrete output of the Arduino Nano, with a PWM signal of 255 units, was 4.783 volts, and 0 corresponded to 0 volts. The linearity of the graph surprised with its accuracy. I was pleasantly surprised, because I always thought that there should be a curved dependence. So you can safely use the capabilities of PWM outputs in measuring serious tasks where you need to generate analog 0 to 5 volts signals. But of course, you should not forget that this signal has ripples that need to be smoothed out using an RC filter. It is also interesting that the loads that we connect to the PWM output are usually nonlinear in nature. For example, LEDs change their brightness in a very nonlinear way depending on the PWM value. The same applies to motors. And now, having seen the resulting graph, we will not sin on the physical features of discrete outputs. It is clear that only the load is not linear in this case. And for the linearization of the control of such actuators, it is necessary to use software methods. But that is another story. Thank you for liking and subscribing, and see you in the next videos.